Hello, everyone, and welcome to our Heart Bunch video. Today, we're going to be talking about a really important topic, talking about five things you need to know about fentanyl and xylazine. Here are the five things. We're going to cover each one together. And this is a timely topic because a recent report from the CDC reported that in 2022, 2 out of 3 overdose deaths were linked to illicitly manufactured fentanyl. And increasingly, xylazine is also found in substances as well. Both are considered sedatives, which makes the combination especially dangerous for slowing down your nervous system and accidental overdose. Also, since fentanyl is an opioid, Narcan can be used to help reverse the effects of an overdose. For a xylazine overdose, the focus is on supporting respiratory function and blood pressure stability. And since the combination is becoming more and more common, we wanted to talk to you about both of these so you can be safe and aware. I'm going to pass it to Drew to talk about fentanyl as a synthetic opioid.
Pharmaceutical fentanyl is used to treat severe pain or terminal illnesses. It's 50 times more potent than heroin and 100 times more potent than morphine. It commonly comes in a liquid or powder form. It's standalone and mixed with other substances like counterfeit pills, methamphetamine, cocaine, and even marijuana in some instances. I'm going to pass the time over to Gabby to tell us more about fentanyl as a leading contributor of overdose death.
When we talk about fentanyl, We want to let you know, people can experience an overdose from a small amount, and that's about the size, the amount that fits on the tip of a pencil. It's very, very little. And it's something that it can't be seen or smelled or tasted. Substances that have fentanyl in them have different amounts in and across them. So meaning that even if if there is a bag of counterfeit pills, each pill can have a different amount within that, even if it comes from that same bag or the same batch. And the last thing to know about fentanyl and why it's the leading contributor of overdose deaths is because when we talk about analogs, which are like variations of the original, they don't show up on traditional toxicology screenings. And right now, the most common analog currently is called carfentanil, which was created for use in large animals. So imagine that being used in humans. So I'm going to turn it over to Tim. He's going to talk about the next couple of tips.
Thank you, Gabby. I'm going to talk about xylazine, as a tranquilizer or non-opioid sedative. It was developed for animal as an animal anesthetic and is not approved for human use. The effects are similar to opioids and opioid overdose, such as difficulty breathing, slowed blood pressure and heart rate, and sedation. Additional symptoms from use include wounds that become infected, skin ulcers, and abscesses. Some people actually experience that quite a bit on the streets, and it causes many issues with people's arms, legs, having ulcers that need to be treated, and actually have even skin grafts if they can't be treated traditionally. So currently, there's no approved medication for treatment of a xylazine overdose. However, giving naloxone can still help because the substance might also contain an opioid like fentanyl. Street names include trank, trank dope, sleep cut, whatever. Xylazine is also a common adulterant, which means secretly or accidentally added. It's found in mixtures of heroin and cocaine, a deadly combination better known as a speedball or dynamite, which you may have heard and seen in some of the movies that are out there. I'm talking about drug use. So we're going to talk about importance of getting help as quickly as possible. Oftentimes, a person may not know they're taking something with fentanyl or xylazine in it. Therefore, it's important to learn CPR and carry naloxone with you in case it is needed. If you're with someone who experiences an overdose, we recommend you call 911, administer naloxone if you're not sure they took an opioid. Because as we spoke before, that opioid can contain xylazine and fentanyl. If you're not breathing, provide rescue breaths if you're comfortable, or at least chest compressions until help arrives. If you need to leave the person even for a minute, put them in the recovery position to allow them to not block an airway if they do have any problems with any regurgitation of substances from their stomach. I'm now going to turn the time to Ashley to talk about recovery and to finish this out here.
Thank you, Tim. And we want to make sure that we talk about recovery because recovery is possible, treatment is effective and works. And so a few different options and resources that we have here listed. If you would like to get connected to recovery resources, you can start that journey and your path here. You can call 211 to get connected to healthcare and social services, including things like housing and food, as well as other needs that you might have. USARA for recovery support resources in the state of Utah. Findtreatment.gov for local substance use treatment providers. 988 for the Suicide and Crisis Hotline and the Department of Substance Abuse and Mental Health in Utah, as well as other local recovery support organizations. And remember, one pathway doesn't work for everyone. You have to find the path that works for you. And just to highlight some of the local events and organizations that are coming up in the next little while and are yearly is Overdose Awareness Day is international every year, August 31st, and Recovery Month is always September every year. And if you are experiencing or are around someone experiencing thoughts of suicide or just want to talk about a crisis and work through it, you can call 988. That is the new Suicide and Crisis Lifeline that will always be available 24/7. And we're going to close it out. Thank you for watching our Heart Bunch video. We hope you follow us on social media and enjoy other content as you're browsing and continue to learn new things. Here are the references and resources that we wanted to share with you as well. And thank you for joining us for this education.